Welcome to this module that is security misconfigurations, and this is on the number 5 from the OWASP top 10. And coming to the previous numbering of this one and the ranking of this one, so this was moving up from the 6th position in the previous edition. 90% of the applications were tested. So most of the time, OWASP top 10 is tested with maximum number of the percentage of applications to get the more insights of that, to uncover the security holes and so on. So this is the very first lesson of security misconfigurations, that is the improper error handling. And improper error handling can also lead to full compromise of the server or the web applications, or simply say the complete control organizations will be under cover of the, or simply say under the attacker's hand to get the full data compromise, and data breaches can also occur. So have a look at the security misconfigurations in a quick way to what this module is going to be covered. So the first thing is the improperly configured permissions on the cloud services and the application stacks to harden the security, unnecessary features and the services enabled or installed, like the unnecessary ports, services, pages, accounts and privileges. So this also includes the permissions, like the privileges here, and the default accounts, passwords are still enabled and unchanged. Error handling reveals the stack traces or other true overly informative error messages to the users that tells the attacker what kind of technologies are being used over the target site. For the upgraded systems, the latest security features are disabled or simply say not configured. Now, in this lesson, we are going to start with this one, the error handling that reveals the stack traces or other overly informative error messages to the users. Now let's see how this actually looks like. So you might have also seen that if any application or the server that doesn't handle the error messages properly, then it throws some error messages with the more informative information. In this case, we can see this is throwing the HTTP 500 status, and for input string null, this is the type exception report, exception handling in this case. Now, what this is revealing here, if we read line by line, there is nothing, but at last we can see this reveals the Apache Tomcat with the version and so on. So we can also be sure that the Apache and the Tomcat is the container in this case has been used, and this is the sign that we can now move to attack the Apache Tomcat. In the next, we can see this is the warning for the SQL injection, like the ODBC fetch array expects parameter to the boolean, and this ODBC is maximum time you will get after the SQL injection vulnerabilities. We can also see the path where the application is there and so on. We can see this is the SQL query error and so on. So we have also installation path where the installations for the applications are there, so we can get the more information. So that is why the security misconfigurations, this is error handling, improper error handling can lead to the full compromise, and also it gives the more informations apart from it is intended to. Now coming to the real world examples and how we can test for that. So application errors gives this kind of errors. So this is the juice shop, and we can see this is the proper error handling. This is not throwing any kind of information that can support, that can help the attacker to move ahead and attack ahead for that application. This simply says an error occurred in the application and your page could not be searched. So if you are the application owner, check your logs for details and so on. There is nothing more like the error messages that says the version and what kind of technologies are being used. So this is the best way, and this is the proper error handling. So that's why I am showing up this one. Now coming to the demonstration part here. So coming to the user information. So if I am going to put the admin, it will be logged in or it doesn't show any error messages, and it sees the user admin and the password admin. But if I am going to put the any other messages, other path or the strings or the data that is unwanted for this application, then the error will be much larger in this case, and that may also reveal the most informative data here. So if I'm going to put the single quote or simply say anything here, this might reveal the stack traces here and the exception handler. And here we can see this is saying that the MySQL database is being used. So hope you have used these kind of the error messages and you understand the error messages about what this throws. This is simple to understand that we had to pause the application or the server in this case to reveal the unwanted data, or simply say confuse the application by putting any kind of the things that is unwanted for this input points. So you have to first locate the input points, then put the random data or simply say the fuzzing data. We will see that later in this examples and in this lesson too. And then check for the responses if it reveals some sort of information and what kind of information. So this is handling the data but not handling the special characters in this case. And we can see the something information to MySQL handler, and the path is also showing up here. And that's all for this one. Now coming to the this is the manual approach that I am taking for this particular one application. But in the penetration testing or the testing engagement, you have the limited time to test the large number of applications and the input points. So this site, suppose for the testing point, have the multiple input points. So if I am going to test for this one, this is the, alright, so this is the capturing, it requires the bub suite. So if I am going to have the login or check for other things, so arbitrary file inclusion, still there is nothing. Let me show you one point here. So this is the DNS lookup, pen test tool, text user info, this is for the same XML validator. This is the input point. We can test anything here that it requires. So if this is going to throw the error, all right, so it is also throwing the error. We need to investigate what kind of error this is and how we can benefit the attack and simply chain the attack further. So that is the part of this one. And this is the manual approach. You can't do this in the engagement because you have the large number of testing and you have the limited time. So you need the automated tools and the automation with the fuzzing list. So if I'm going for the same thing and coming up to the bub suite here, so this is the bub suite. Let me copy the URL for this one. I'm going to home, simply copy this and hit enter. Alright, so now we are here, coming once again to the bub suite. Intercept is off, turn it on. Now coming to input point here to say, for example, SQL injection, it has been captured here. Now if I am going to, alright, so this is this doesn't require to be captured. Let me go to put here. So this one and this one, after that turn it on, then hit enter, and now we have the parameter, that is the username and the password. Now I will send it to the intruder to automate this task, and let me send it once again to intruder, and this time it is sent. going to intruder. Now we have the marker for the payload marker here in this case here. So I'm going to clear this all and putting the username only to mark this marker for attack and for the password too to add. And if I want to don't place the marker to all places, I can do this all or simply one place. So if I'm going to put at one place, we can use the sniper attack. We have the four types of the attack type here. So the cluster bomb, pitchfork, battering ram, and the sniper. So every attack type have the different kind of the capabilities, and it does. So going to the sniper attack for the first parameter, username parameter, and going to payloads, going to load the payloads. Here we have the fuzzing full. So let me show you what this is going to do. Otherwise, we can also use the payload type from here. So simply type the runtime and select the file. But this will not show up what's inside the file that I am loading here. So let me show you fuzzingfull.txt. And now we can see this is going to fuzz for every kind of the vulnerabilities and the issues. We can see this starts from the SQL injection, then it goes to the SQL injection and other like the update, union, and the all right. So this is not all for the all kind of vulnerabilities. This is for the SQL injection only. And this is the list of from the Bub Suite professional editions that I have copied to the list. Now coming to start this attack. If I'm going to start the attack for this payload, going to the positions, start the attack at one position. And it is going to conduct this too, and it will try to find out the information or the it will try to find out for the vulnerabilities. So this is simply going to fuzz at that point to find out if this is throwing some error or not. Going to response, we can see that in the render tag if this is showing some of the errors or not, so we can be sure. There are many things that we have learned in the previous lessons, and so on. We can see the syntax error, that is the SQL, and that shows the MySQL is there. Coming to the next one, we can also be sure from here. And all right, so this doesn't throw some error and it doesn't reveal some information. Now coming to this one, this also reveals that too. We can see the client information is the version. So this is also showing up the version for that MySQL database in this case. Error execution query. In the countermeasures, we will understand how this can be stopped and how this information can be customized to show up the information that what we want. And this all happens because of the developers leave it and don't remember to simply remove these kind of things and don't want to customize it, or simply say the lack of the knowledges, experiences for the development. So this is the kind of the automations that we can do for. Coming back once again to our information here, security misconfigurations. In the next upcoming sessions, we will see that how everything like the default accounts and the passwords. So all these are the kind of the discussions that we need to or simply check the accounts on the system one by one. So we have seen the error handling that it traces. Now let's have a look over what it can lead to. So the errors sometimes rise as the stack traces that we've seen in the MySQL kind of the attacks. Network timeouts, that also shows when the application is loading or there are the overloads over the way applications, then there will be network timeouts, and this can also throws some error messages with the informative data. Input mismatch, so as we did in the SQL point where we put at the single quote, that was the input mismatch and the memory dumps. Sometimes you get the memory dumps in the real world sites as well. Now what it can lead to and what the attackers can get. So understand the APIs being used internally, it also throws the errors that can lead to throws the information about what kind of APIs are being used internally, what versions are there, what informations are there. Map the various services integrating with each other by gaining insight on internal systems. So it can simply say this can change the attack from the outside to the inside with the simple one vulnerabilities or simple one information that attacker can chain together with the other vulnerabilities. We can gather the versions and types of applications being used because it throws the MySQL error and it also shows the 5.1.0 or 2 was used. The attacker can DOS the system by forcing the system into a deadlock or simply unhandled exception errors that sends a panic signal to the engine running it. Controls that bypasses where a certain exception is not restricted by the logic set and so on. So these are the some circumstances in which the stack traces and timeouts and input mismatch and memory dumps can leads to these kind of attacks, and this kind of attacks further can leverage the power of another user in the privilege escalation, in the SSRF, that is the server-side request forgery, SQL injections, and so on. So in case of this one, like the SQL injection that it throws, it can lead to complete full takeover of that because it shows it have the SQL injection vulnerabilities and attacker now also knows that the database is MySQL. So they can now simply put inside the SQL map and simply start attacking automatically. See you in the next lessons. You can try out in the lab or simply say on the open sites or the real sites that have the vulnerabilities reward programs, or that is called the bug bounty hunting programs on, or that organizations are the part of that, so that you will not be in trouble. See you in the next lessons. Thank you.